nice color. Here are the materials needed. Hip curve, L-square, French curve, scissors, marker, pencil, tape measure, your front and back bodies, and the pattern paper. The first procedure is you have to fold your pattern paper like this into equal halves. And after that, you have to measure your neckline. The measurement of my neckline is 9 inches. So from this folded area of your pattern paper, you will start your measurement and mark it as point B. From this folded area of your pattern, you're going to start your measurement. The measurement is 9 inches. And it is your point B. After that, you're going to measure 2 inches upward from the folded area. It is for the stand collar height. It is your point C. And another 2 inches upward from point C. And this is your point D. And now, let us move on to the collar leaf of our rubinized collar. My rubinized collar I want is 5 inches wide. So, from point D, I'm going to measure 5 inches upward and mark it as point E. And draw a horizontal line from this. This is the collar leaf height. After this, we're going to draw another vertical line from point B up to the end of the pattern. This is the height of your collar. After you draw your vertical line here, measure 1 inch inside your pattern. And mark it as point F. After that, draw again vertical line as what you do in point B. After you draw vertical line, back again to the baseline of your pattern and measure 4 inches inside the pattern. And mark it as point G. After you measure 4 inches, draw again vertical line just what you did in point B and F. After you create your vertical line, connect point C to point G. Draw only horizontal line to meet this vertical line. And now it is your point H. After this, measure 1 inch upward from point F. And that is your point I. After that, draw curved line using the hip curve in the stand collar of your trubinice. Make sure to connect it at your point H. Do this kind of process in the same step in point I and G. And now you have your point J and K. And now you have your stand collar. After that, connect point D to the other side of your pattern using your L square. And do the reverse curved line as what you did earlier. After this reverse curved line, from this intersection, draw a slanting line to connect this point E. Use your L square. And now you have your point M. After this, you have to draw another curved line for the details of your stand column. Use a French curve to connect K to the intersection. And to make a perfect curve. And now it is the last step for the trubinized collar. Lastly, to make it clear, I will highlight the important lines to this. And now you have your trubinized collar. You know just what to say. Shit, that's